Hi, my name is Emma Archer. I'm a product manager on Dynamics 365 Virtual Agent for Customer Service. And today I'd like to walk you through how to use the analytics and chat transcripts to improve the performance of your bot. On the left-hand side here, you can see in the chat test canvas a conversation that I've already had with the bot regarding gift cards and whether or not what my remaining balance is. And you can see that the conversation ran its course and the bot was able to help me. And at the end of that, the bot asked, "Did this answer your question?" And I replied, "Yes." This is synonymous with what we call our end of conversation survey. And this is important because it plays into what shows up as a resolved session. And then this is what we call the CSAT survey, and that we'll see played out in the customer satisfaction tab, where we ask the customer to rate the bot overall bot experience through terrible through excellent, which is 1 through 5. So let me walk us through what we have in terms of the analytics on the core summary view. You see here a KPI header, which has the core top KPIs. You also see you have the ability to filter by the last 7 days or the last 30 days. I'm sticking with the last 7 days here. You can see we have 3 tabs, summary, customer satisfaction and sessions, which we'll walk through all of them. What we see here is in this particular bot, which I've had running for about 6 days, I've had about 198 sessions total. Now, of which those 85% of them have been engaged sessions. Now, what does that mean? An engaged session is one where the bot has been able to take a look at what the customer asked and find a topic that could potentially help solve the customer's question. So we only solved, the bot only was able to help with approximately 85%, which maps to about 160 sessions. So there were about 30 sessions that the bot wasn't able to help with, and those are defined as our unengaged sessions. And those are reflected here in the red in this particular chart, the engagement over time. So this is one of the first areas that I would want to look at in terms of being able to focus on what those questions were and seeing what content I could add, what new topics I could add to my bot to help address those questions. Because the higher the engagement rate, the better performing my bot. And then let's look at of this engaged rate, the 160 or so sessions that we did have that were engaged, they really fall into one of 3 outcomes, session outcomes. They're either successfully resolved, or they're escalated, or they're abandoned. When you see the resolved, this example, the resolved here, this is an example on the left-hand side of a chat that was successfully resolved, because the customer, when asked about did this solve the question, they said yes. Now, if the customer had answered yes, or if the customer had not answered, all fall into this bucket of resolved. Only if the customer had specifically said no here, they would be prompted to, would they like to speak to a human agent, would that go into the escalated bucket. And then the abandoned are classified as those that the customer may have been engaging with the bot and dropped off partway through, perhaps felt that the bot wasn't understanding, perhaps got distracted with something else and left the conversation. When that happens, we do wait for about an hour before we classify it as an abandoned session. So the next area that I would look at in terms of being able to improve my content is I'd really want to focus on the high number of escalated and abandoned, and what I can do to help reduce the numbers there. So the first thing I'd do is I'd take a look at the escalation rate drivers, and I'd look at the specific topics here. So for example, this one, returns, exchange and refund order policy. When I hover here, I can see that the impact is 2%, What that means is this particular single topic is impacting my overall escalation rate by 2%. So if I can reduce the number of escalations coming through here by addressing them more effectively with perhaps better content, then instead of seeing 20 here, I would see 18, which is obviously a goal that one wants. I would focus on looking at ways to reduce the number, and I'd take the same approach with the abandoned. So I'd look at those that are high, and so I'd maybe start by looking at the pay bill and the cancel membership, because between those two, they impact that abandon rate by 3%. So if you could reduce the number of abandoned, you could reduce that from 15 to 12, which is well worth doing. So one of the ways that you would do that is you would look at the individual sessions associated, and we will see that in a moment. But before we go there, let's just take a quick look at what we have on the customer satisfaction tab. So this tab, it just gives you a focused view based on how the customers rated the overall experience. And you can see these are every topic that had customer sat filled in for it. And you can probably the easiest thing to do is sort by either the average CSAT or the engaged sessions to see which ones you had highest volume of. So store location, I had a pretty high volume of engaged sessions, but the CSAT for that was not that great. So what could I do to look at ways to improve that CSAT? I'd probably want to look at the lowest performers, but one has to also look at, you know, the lowest performers plus the highest volume. So there's no point investing a lot of energy in a low performer if very few people are asking about it. So I would use this to drill in on the CSAT. This average CSAT score is the overall CSAT for my entire bot. And so for every topic that I have within my bot, which I think I've got 20 or 30 topics right now. So this shows the overall performance, 4.2 out of 5, not bad. And then this shows of the ones that customers that did fill in the CSAT, there were about 80 completed sessions. There were about 18 that didn't complete. The other thing to say is that we only show the CSAT today when you've said yes to that question. So it's biased towards the positive. You can change that, but this is how it's currently configured. And then the next place I would go is the sessions tab, and here I would download the sessions. The other thing to say is for the analytics that you saw on these two tabs, you have to wait an hour. When you download the sessions, they are available immediately, even if you've just created a session like 2 minutes ago. So when you download, it opens up a file like this, and then you have to format it by putting the filters on and locking on the headers. I've actually already done that just to save us a wee bit of time. So let me navigate to that. And you can see here, I've actually filtered by session outcome already. So I'm going to pivot and move from abandoned to unengaged sessions here. And here I'm going to look at what questions was I being asked, was the bot being asked, that we didn't have content for. So we can see here, looks like there are a couple of common themes. I can see that we're being asked about formula for standard deviation quite a few times. We're being asked about the price of an Ergo keyboard for a Surface. And so those are two obvious areas I would consider adding topics for. We're also being asked some sort of fun questions about, you know, can you tell me a joke today? What's your favorite color? These you'll need to think about whether or not, what kind of persona you want the bot to have, whether or not you want it to have some sort of fun questions interwoven, or whether or not you want to keep it, you know, what's the voice of your bot? Is it more of a business tone, or is it lighter? So that's something to consider. The common things that I would focus on changing are really, aside from the unengaged sessions, I would pivot and look at the abandoned, and I'd actually go through those sessions to see if there are clues as to why the customer abandoned and dropped off. And I would do the same for the resolved, for the escalated sessions. And really, there are really what I see is four common themes that are areas for improvement: either unengaged sessions or poor quality content where, you know, the quality of the answer is just not great, or incomplete topics and dialogues. That's the third one. And then the fourth one is really overlapping triggers. And what happens there is you have a topic, you know, using a trigger, and then you have another topic using the same trigger. What will happen is when the customer asks a question, say both of them are asking about something to do with order, but it's not clear what, and then perhaps you've got order as a trigger on both of them, then the bot's going to ask a "did you mean" question to the customer to try and, you know, clarify, are they after this topic or are they after this topic? And so you want to try, where possible, to avoid that. You want to try to make the triggers less ambiguous. So those are kind of the four key areas that I would focus on. So in conclusion, you will have to iterate and focus your customer content team on constantly improving the content, because you will find that the questions that you're being asked into your bot will change over time, and you will need to add content and keep the bot up to date in order to maintain good performance. Thank you very much for listening.